the Pyramid of the Robot.
I'm sure you guys remember about my encounters with the two lost SpongeBob episodes, being the lost internship recreation of SpongeBob You're Fired, and SpongeBob Can't Take It. Well, the third episode I encountered was the scariest one of all, and trust me, you'll be scared too. I was on vacation at Myrtle Beach. I was at the beach, and I was making a sandcastle. After I finished making the sandcastle, I went on a walk on the sand. However, while I was walking, my foot felt a sense of cardboard. I stopped walking, grabbed my shovel, and dug out a cardboard box with a VHS tape inside it. The tape was yellow, on its label was the old SpongeBob SquarePants logo, and under it was text that said, Season 1. Wow, a Season 1 SpongeBob VHS, I should watch this and see the episodes. I said. I showed the tape to my mom and asked her if I could go back to the hotel and watch it, and she replied.
Okay, sweetheart. We'll see you in 1 hour and 30 minutes.
I then went back to the hotel, took a shower, got dressed, inserted the tape into the VCR, grabbed my candy, got my Pepsi, and sat down ready to watch this VHS. The VHS began with the Nickelodeon fish ident, however this time it wasn't scary, instead it was normal, and the same thing can be said to the Paramount DVD logo because it was also normal. After that, the first episode immediately began with the intro, then the title card came up, and I realized it was the episode Bubble Stand. I was so happy that I jumped up and down because this was my favorite Season 1 episode. I watched the first 9 episodes, which were Bubble Stand, Employee of the Month, Fun, Naughty Nautical Neighbors, Pizza Delivery, Karate Choppers, Squidward the Unfriendly Ghost, Squeaky Boots, and Sleepy Time. However, the 10th episode I watched was crazy and different. After the intro played, the title card came up. The title card was a dark blue background with orangish yellow text with a dark red outline that said, Chaos. The happy-go-lucky music played in the background, then the credits played as normal, and then the bubble transition played as it showed an outside view of the Krusty Krab. The usual Krusty Krab music played in the background as it went to an inside shot of the Krusty Krab with Squidward at the cash register reading his newspaper, while Mr. Krabs can be seen right next to him just relaxing. Mr. Krabs then says to Squidward,
Mr. Squidward, where is SpongeBob?
In which Squidward replies,
I don't know, Mr. Krabs.
After Squidward said that, the sound of SpongeBob walking could be heard, and after 10 seconds the front door opens to reveal SpongeBob with his Krusty Krab hat on. He then says,
Good morning, Krusty Krab!
Both Squidward and Mr. Krabs replied with,
Good morning, SpongeBob! Nice to see you!
SpongeBob then walks to Squidward and Mr. Krabs, and says,
So are you guys ready for another great day of work?
In which Squidward replies with,
Well, I never thought I would say this, but I'm actually ready for a great day of work.
SpongeBob replies with,
What makes you say that, Squidward?
In which Squidward replies,
Well, it's just that even though you can be really annoying and no-see, I actually really like you as a friend, and that's why I'm happy.
SpongeBob then replies with,
Ah, that's so cute, Squidward!
Mr. Krabs then says to SpongeBob and Squidward,
Boyos, I want you two to report to me office.
In which SpongeBob and Squidward replied with,
Aye, Captain!
As they went into the office. It then cuts to Mr. Krabs' office as Mr. Krabs sits down on his office chair, while SpongeBob sits down on one of the chairs, and Squidward stands next to it. SpongeBob then says,
So, Mr. Krabs, why did you bring us here?
Squidward also says,
Yeah, why did you bring us to your office?
Mr. Krabs then replies to the two,
Well, boyos, today is not any ordinary day. In fact, it's a very special day.
Squidward and SpongeBob then both ask the question,
What makes today so special?
Yeah, what's so special about today?
In which Mr. Krabs replies with,
Today's Super Save Friday, which means we're having a big special that will have limited stock.
SpongeBob replied with,
Wow, that's so awesome. What's the big special gonna be?
Mr. Krabs replies with,
Well, our special is gonna be the Super Meal Combo, coming with a double Krabby Patty, an extra large kelp soda, and an extra big bunch of fries, together for just $3.99.
Holy fish sticks!
SpongeBob cheered.
So, boys, get the restaurant ready! We're about to begin!
Mr. Krabs cheered. The three then exit the room, and begin to get the Krusty Krab ready. First they clean off the tables, then they raise the sign, and lastly, they pull up a big banner across the entrance of the Krusty Krab saying, "Big sale coming today." After that they went inside and sit down in the cashier booth as SpongeBob says.
And now, we wait for the customers.
It then cuts to a time card saying,
1 hour and 30 minutes later.
And it cuts to a shot of the Krusty Krab with boats all around it, and there was honking and beeping sounds all over the place. It then went to an inside shot of the Krusty Krab, where there were tons and tons of customers in a big line shouting at Squidward and Mr. Krabs. Squidward then says,
"Wow, I didn't expect we'd get so many customers so quickly, Mr. Krabs."
In which Mr. Krabs replies,
"Yo, we're gonna be rich as shit after this."
SpongeBob then dings the bell and brings out the last combo they had.
"Order up!"
SpongeBob cheered. He then passes the tray to Squidward and he gives it to the customer.
"Thank you for dining at the Krusty Krab. Hope to see you again."
"Thank you,"
the customer said, before walking out the doors. Then the next customer came. The customer was a female fish. She had pink skin, red hair, thick eyelashes, purple eyes, a red dress, and orange shoes.
"Hello, ma'am. Welcome to the Krusty Krab. May I take your order?"
Squidward asks the customer.
"Yes, I would like the super meal combo, please,"
the female customer says.
"Oh, I'm sorry, but we have sold the last one to that customer over there. Would you like something else?"
Squidward asks. Then the fish's eyes turn from purple to dark red.
"What? Are you kidding me? I waited 1 hour, and now I can't get a stupid combo."
The female fish yells at Squidward.
"Listen, I'm sorry. I promise we have other stuff. I promise,"
Squidward says, trying to calm down the customer.
"Hey everyone, guess what? We waited 1 hour and 30 minutes, and now we can't get our food,"
the customer yells to everyone. The people in the line all begin to get mad and started a riot to attack.
"That's it, everybody! Attack!"
the female customer shouted. The customers then charged towards the cash register, and while this was happening, Mr. Krabs and Squidward were screaming, but their screams didn't sound fake, they sounded like their actors were scared out of life. The customer then picked up the cashier boat and began throwing it around, and smashing it into various things such as the tables, the door to Mr. Krabs' office, heck, they even destroyed one of the wooden poles, and when they did, the pole fell down and crashed into the kitchen, causing the grill to catch on fire. SpongeBob sees what's going on and lets out a super loud scream, like with Mr. Krabs and Squidward. His scream sounded like his actor Tom Kenny was scared out of his life.
"I gotta do something!"
SpongeBob shouted as he ran around the kitchen screaming in fear. Then the same female fish from earlier came in with five other customers, including one that resembled Tom the Chocolate Pie.
"Alright, SpongeHead, any final words?"
the pink fish said.
"You're not gonna like what we're gonna do to you,"
the white-haired fish said.
"So loud! Goodbye!"
Tom said.
"No way, don't do this to me! No, I'm just a regular fry cook! No, no, no!"
SpongeBob begged and screamed. The customers then jumped towards SpongeBob. Right before they were about to make contact with the ladder, the screen went back to Mr. Krabs and Squidward being rocked around in the boat. Mr. Krabs shouted,
"SpongeBob, hurry up with these orders!"
Squidward then sees a little wooden platform on one of the wooden poles.
"Quick, Mr. Krabs, jump to the platform!"
Squidward shouts as they jump to the platform, no longer being carried by the wave of angry customers.
"Phew, that was close!"
Before Mr. Krabs could finish talking, they are both cut off by the sound of SpongeBob's muffled screams coming from the kitchen.
"SpongeBob!"
Squidward and Mr. Krabs both shouted in fear. Squidward then sees the opening to the kitchen and says,
"Mr. Krabs, I'm gonna jump to the kitchen."
In which Mr. Krabs replies with,
"Well, if you jump, I'm gonna jump with you."
The two then hold hands, and with all their momentum, jump down to the kitchen screaming. It was so fast that a slow motion effect was added, very familiar to those action movies. Once the two enter the kitchen, they both gasp at what they see. It was SpongeBob lying down, hurt badly. His arms and legs were cracked in half, his chest had a big bruise on it, his nose was bleeding, his teeth were cracked, and his left eye was a black eye. Squidward immediately took SpongeBob to the office, setting him next to the desk, grabs Mr. Krabs' phone, and dials 911. He talks with the police and says,
"We have a big accident, and a majorly injured sponge here at the Krusty Krab."
The police replied with,
"What? Okay, we're coming right now."
Squidward then replies,
"Yeah, there was a fight that broke out. We have destruction, fighting, punching. I need cops. I need doctors. I need everything."
The police finished the call with,
"Okay, we've got everything ready. We're coming now."
As the call ended, Squidward then came back to the kitchen and gasped at what was going on. Mr. Krabs and the customers that attacked SpongeBob were all fighting.
"Everyone stop!"
Squidward says, as he drove Mr. Krabs and the customers away from each other, breaking up the fight. The cops and doctors walked in, as they took the customers away, and the doctors took SpongeBob to the hospital. Mr. Krabs then kicks everybody out, and yells out,
"The Krusty Krab is officially closed permanently until further notice!"
As he walks back into the Krusty Krab with Squidward, and they both sit on the table.
"Oh man, that was insane!"
Squidward said out of breath.
"Yeah, I hope me boy SpongeBob is gonna be okay,"
Mr. Krabs said.
"Me too,"
Squidward replied. The bubble transition played as it showed the hospital. It then went inside to show SpongeBob in a hospital bed, with a white dress on him, bandages on his body, and a heart monitor next to him. The doctor then walked in. The doctor had lime green skin, blue eyes, red stripes, a pair of red glasses, a clipboard, and a doctor suit on. He then spoke, his voice resembled that of Tim Allen, known for playing Buzz Lightyear in the Toy Story movies.
"Mr. SquarePants, you have some visitors that would like to see you."
"Let them in, I want all the company I can get,"
SpongeBob said. The doctor then opened the door to reveal Mr. Krabs and Squidward. They then walk to SpongeBob and sit down on his bed.
"So SpongeBob, are you feeling any better?"
Mr. Krabs asks SpongeBob.
"Yeah, just a little bit,"
SpongeBob says.
"Well, it appears that the damage to his body has caused severe damage to his bones, so he'll have to stay here for 3 weeks,"
the doctor said.
"Oh no, that's very bad,"
Squidward says.
"Don't worry, Mr. Squidward, we'll make sure the boy is okay,"
Mr. Krabs says before looking at SpongeBob and asking,
"So SpongeBob, what do you want to do?"
In which SpongeBob replies,
"Can we watch Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy?"
"Sure, let me turn on the TV,"
Mr. Krabs says as he grabs the remote, turns the TV on, and begins flipping through channels before Squidward stops him by saying,
"Look, Mr. Krabs, it's the news."
The three then watch the news report.
"I am a realistic talking fish head, and this is today's news. In an accident that occurred 5 hours ago, a giant incident occurred today here at the Krusty Krab, where a yellow sponge was injured due to a big beating. We now go to Perch Perkins. Now to you, Perch."
The fish said as it went to a shot of Perch standing outside of the Krusty Krab.
"Thanks, Mr. Fish. I am Perch Perkins reporting live to you from the Krusty Krab, where 5 hours ago the incident occurred. We now talk with Plankton, who was a witness of the incident,"
Perch said as Plankton walked on the screen.
"Mr. Plankton, please describe what you say,"
Perch says as he passes the mic to Plankton.
"When I was minding my business at the Chum Bucket, trying to think of a plan to steal the formula, when all of a sudden, I hear these sounds of banging, destruction, and chaos. So I went to the top of the bucket, stood on top of my hand, only to see a giant riot happening at the Krusty Krab. I didn't know what to do, so I went back inside my restaurant,"
Plankton said.
"Wow, what a story. Now back to you, Mr. Fish,"
Perch said as it went back to the newsroom.
"Thank you, Perch, and now we see you later for more updates,"
Mr. Fish says as Mr. Krabs turns off the TV.
"Well, this was certainly a crazy day,"
Mr. Krabs said.
"Yeah, you're right, Mr. Krabs,"
Squidward says.
"But now things are looking up. As long as you guys are with me, I'm always gonna be happy. I love you guys,"
SpongeBob says as he, Mr. Krabs, and Squidward all embrace a big hug. As they hug it out, the episode fades to black, and cuts to the credits. This time the United Plankton Pictures and Nickelodeon logos were normal, unlike the last ones I saw. After the logos played, the screen cut to black, and the tape ejected. I was shocked at what I've seen. I'd never expect to see a show as kid-friendly like SpongeBob have this kind of an episode. When my family came back, I showed them the footage, and they were shocked. I grabbed a few screenshots of the VHS before my mom hid it in the closet. To be honest though, even though that episode was scary and crazy as ever, I actually really enjoyed it. It had a nice plot, crazy action scenes, heartbreaking scenes, and even gave us some character development for Squidward and Mr. Krabs. So if you ever find this episode, I highly recommend checking it out, because you may like it just as much as I did. This is a goodbye, see you again when I encounter a lost episode. P.S., this episode is actually a sequel to the episode, Insanity.